And if you seek a power to overcome a power, you are in a false identity. You are a human being again. You are in a second mind again. Only a second mind seeks a power to overcome a power. Does the one mind of God seek a power to overcome a power? Is there another mind? And if there is only one invisible, infinite mind, what mind are you using to seek another power? A mind that isn't. A hypnotized mind. You've let go of the kite, you've gone into two-ness, into a second mind. Now there's only one mind, there's only one power, that power is God. And therefore there is no other power to oppose the power of God. Why do I have to seek God to oppose the power that I have invented, if there is no other power? Now then, part of holding on to the kite is the ability to not seek God power, but to accept that God power is the only power, and therefore I need no power to overcome any power in this world. Now let's translate that down to the foot. I need no power to overcome this swollen, painful foot. And if I need a power, then I am saying that this foot has power, and I need a power that is greater than that power. But instead, let's recognize the hypnosis, and let's get into that consciousness which is immune to hypnosis, and see if that was really a power. And so we go looking for the consciousness that is immune to the powers of this world. We seek the kingdom of God, because that's where we're going to find the consciousness that is immune to the powers of this world. We should have been in that kingdom, but we weren't, and that's why we have the foot. And now we go to that kingdom where the power is. Where is it? Within me. The kingdom of God within you. And where is within you? How do you get within you? This world, we decided, was a five-sense concept. To get within you, you must get out of the five senses. As long as you're in the five senses, you're in this world of powers. Suddenly you find that silence and loving God are one and the same thing. To love God is to be silent before God. To be in your own mind is to love yourself. And so you get out of yourself into silence, the silence of the senses, and this is within. And in your silence, you are doing the best you know how to express your love of God. You're out of the image area. There are no images at this place. You cannot be instantly brainwashed by images coming through your sense of sight and your sense of touch below the level of your perception. You are coming unto me, the Christ who stands on this holy ground. You are accepting that God alone is power, and now a great weight drops from your mind with the realization that because God is power, and only God is power, and the power of God is only for love, for harmony, for truth, for peace, that God did not ordain this foot. God did not bring this foot to you. Well, who did if God didn't? God is the only power. And you're stuck with one answer. There's nobody and no power to bring it to you. You've just got an image. That's all you've got. An image. An image so powerful in so many ways that you had accepted it. And the realization that all it is an image stares you in the face for quite a while before something in you begins to say, well, if it's an image, it has no power. And the voice says, well, isn't that what I've been telling you for 5,000 years? It's an image and it has no power. And you say, but if it has no power, how can it keep me from standing on it? And the voice says, it can't. It can't keep you from standing on it. Your false consciousness is keeping you from standing on it. You mean I can stand on it? There is no power to keep you from it. God power says be perfect. It doesn't say you can't walk. God power says be perfect. You're coming up to a place where something in you begins to say, then if God power wants me to do it, I can do it. That's right, you can do it. You're losing the paralysis of thought, which had frozen you at a place that said, I can't do it. It won't hold me. It's painful. It's blue, it's red, it's swollen. But all of these are little images which add up to the one great image of a foot that won't work. It's an image in thought. Every problem is an image in thought. And an image has no power. I can't tell you where it comes, but suddenly you're certain. I can walk on that foot. And the moment you feel this, I can, you are beginning to have the understanding in you which externalizes as walking on the foot. That which you know inside becomes that which you do out there. And before you know it, you're quite convinced you can. The spirit is broken through that soul center. And you're catching the notion that God being power, there's no power on earth to prevent God from walking. God is the power of my being, or I wouldn't be here. There's no power to stop me from walking. And you see now the spirit is quickening, quickening, quickening. And it's that spirit quickening which changes the whole vibration set up in ratio. And before you know it, the quickened spirit dissolves the paralysis which says it's painful, it's swollen, I can't walk. And now you're determined you certainly can. And all of this may take place in 40, 50 seconds. Now you just can't wait to get started. But you don't want to make a fool of yourself, so you wait a while. You're convinced you can do it. And then the consciousness that is convinced it can do it, if it becomes spiritual enough, if it has the word, if it has the awareness, if this is not your mind trying to determine something, but is a true impulse from within, you'll discover that your consciousness that you can do it is there because something has already happened in that foot to remove the illusion, and then the next thing you know, you're walking on it. And the pain is decreasing. And you can apply that to any problem. But you must accept that God alone is power, and that every other power in this world is a pretender, a lie, a claim. Because this world is non-power. There is no power in this world. All power is in Christ. And Christ is not in this world, because this world is concept. But Christ is here, for this is the kingdom of God. My kingdom is right here where you stand, and Christ is in it, and Christ is in you, and as you accept this Christ in you, against all your human experience, and hold on to this, you're walking the waters of spirit. You're walking the gap, and you will have to walk that gap. There is no human understanding that will take you across it. And it was made that way, so you would have to do it in reliance on the Spirit. For in your reliance on the Spirit to take you across that gap, you will develop that consciousness of the Christ which is necessary for the opening of the kingdom of God on earth. Now this is what we all have faced. Some of us have taken some of those steps. Some of us have done it 20 times and 30 times and 40 times, and we find that the gap is becoming smaller and smaller. Some of us are finding that the trials are increasing in tempo and in depth. But what of it? We're all heading toward one place: the preparation for the removal of the false consciousness of this earth. That consciousness which is still looking for God to come here, and we are accepting that God is here. We are accepting that the power of God is here. That where the presence is the power. That the love is here. And we are also finding that every appearance of every negative about God, whether it be hate or famine or lack or limitation, can only be here because it is an imitation of the reality that is already here. There could be no hate on this earth if there weren't invisible love. Always, those things that we see as the evils are the imitation of the reality that is here in the invisible. Be sure that wherever you look at any form of discord, invisibly is its very opposite. That is why the discord is there. For you to look through it, accepting the opposite in spite of your human experience, and to walk the gap. Then you are sowing not to the flesh, not to the experience of the senses. You are sowing to the unseen. Now the word cognize is a very interesting word. You have seen it many times and you've heard it on the tapes of Joel. He doesn't just say know this or understand this, he'll say cognize, cognize, cognize. And it suddenly hit me just how important that word is. Because cognize comes from the same root that means to know. And this is a different kind of knowing than people are used to knowing. To cognize means to come into the awareness of truth. To know with is the root of it. To know with. And to know with means to know that that which is invisible is there. To cognize means to become aware of the invisible which is here with us now. That's what cognize means when he uses it. Be aware of that which your human mind cannot see is the meaning of cognize when Joel uses it. Be aware of the unseen. Know that it is there. Acknowledge the unseen. Cognize. Come into oneness with the unseen. And that's so different than just the dictionary meaning of it. There's something in the legal practice that seems to be aware of this. It's called cognizance. And you take cognizance of something in the legal practice and you agree with something even though you're not aware of what it is. And strangely, there's a similarity to the cognizance of the invisible spirit. It's to recognize what is invisibly present. Now then, we are becoming cognizant of the invisible kingdom in our midst. We are learning that life is not in this form. And life does not depend on this form. We're learning that this form is in life, and this form depends on life. And that we are life and not form. And this is contrary to human experience. But if we don't let go of the kite, if we don't let go of the realization that when God says, be ye perfect, that means every quality of God must be where you are now. And pick the quality you need at the moment and know it's there, and it's yours. And even though you can't see it, it is yours, and hold it. It is your invisible quality. It is the meat the world knows not of. That's one way, and there's one more. And every time you violate this one more, you will find you've also violated the principle of knowing that the quality of God you need is right there in you now. You can never accept that there is another being on this earth than God. That's another way you must hold the kite. Everything in your experience is going to force you to that final realization. You cannot accept that there is another being on this earth than God. There is only one God, and that is the only being on the earth.
It is like saying there is one ocean. And there may be 6 million waves,
but they are all in that one ocean. And the reason we must come to this is because God being all,
when we accept the allness of God,
where can we look and find an unfriendly power or an unfriendly condition that can be real? If we have accepted that God is the only being, where will you look and find a being that is an enemy? Where would you find an atom bomb that is real? If God is the only being, can an atom bomb exist in God? And so we come finally to why Joel can say, the atom bomb has no power. There's no power to make you blind. Your body can be neither sick nor well. God is the only being, and all powers exist because we do not accept the one being that is God on the terms that this God has expressed. I am the one, and beside me there is no other. And that you must hold. It is not your experience. It is not on the evidence of your naked senses, but you must take God's word for it. And therefore you hold to God is the only being. And therefore you are centered in God. You are centered in I. And everywhere you look, no matter what you see, you must redeem the appearance to the knowledge that God is there, there and there and there. If you let go, there goes your kite. There goes your eternal life. There goes your oneness with God. Unless you are accepting constant oneness with God, you're in two-ness. And therefore you cannot let go. To the degree that you let go, to that degree you will have the opposites of this world. To the degree that you hold on in spite of your experience, in spite of your sensations, in spite of your sensibilities, to the degree that you hold to the invisible, that God is all, to that degree the power of God will express in you, ultimately leading to the consciousness of God, which you are clinging to. Then your consciousness will not be human. It will be a consciousness which knows the Father aright. And your knowing of the Father aright is the life eternal, which the Christ
tells us is our life. When we know God aright,
my kingdom is the only kingdom there is. And my kingdom isn't hidden behind a bush. It isn't hidden behind a planet. My kingdom is all there is. There is no other. Where you walk is my kingdom. And the world you think you're walking in is the concept about my kingdom. You cannot walk in a concept. Accept my kingdom here, my presence here, my power here, my allness here, as your power, your presence, your allness, and that is where the dominion is that we were given in Genesis. Dominion is not in a man or a woman, not in a human, not in a concept, not in a physical form. Dominion is in the Son of God, the Christ,
which walks in the kingdom of God. And you must accept
that identity. You must hold to that identity. You must reject all other, not only in yourself, but in everyone you know. You must accept the invisible Christ on earth, everywhere, in everyone. And this alone is the oneness which lifts you into the consciousness which walks the gap. And this is the way to illumination. Let's be still on this a moment.
Only the power of God is functioning where you stand now. There is no other power functioning where you stand. This becomes a permanent realization. Only the power of God functions where I stand. Therefore, I need fear nothing, no person, no condition in this universe. This must be held to. Thou shalt have no other power before me, no other God before me. Overcoming then is the knowing that God's power is where I stand, for I am the Son of God. The world will tempt you out of that every day. The entire world will continue to tempt you out of that. It is the nature of the world to do that. It is the nature of the Christ not to be tempted. I thank you very much.